creatives, and welcome to another video. So today I'm here to share a snail mail flipbook tutorial with me, and I'm using two card bases as the base of my flipbook. So I hope that you will enjoy this snail mail flipbook tutorial, and if you have any questions, always feel free to leave them down below in the description box. So I'm using two standard size card bases for this, and I'm going to cut 1-inch strips of paper from this craft paper cardstock, so it's not really thick, and I'm going to score that 1/2 inch, so you have this hinge that we can adhere to our card bases to create a very cool pocket. So I am taking my two card bases, and they are A6 sized, so it doesn't really matter which size you use because the process is the same. Just take two standard card bases. I'm going to adhere two of these pieces to the sides first to create a hinge for my pocket, because this is quite sturdy cardstock, and if I want to open and close it, it needs a little bit of room to open and close. So that is what I'm going to create with this hinge system. So I just adhered these pieces of paper, I glued down one side of the scored paper, and I'm going to cut it off. I usually do this because I always cut everything either too short or too long, so this is my way around that. And it doesn't have to be pretty, so I'm just using this scrap piece of paper. I'm going to connect them to each other to create this bottom part, because that is also a very important part of your pocket, that it has a little bit of room for you to add some goodies in there. Or in my case, I'm going to create my own writing paper later on in this video, and I'm going to add that inside of this pocket. I am going to adhere this bottom piece as well, but it doesn't have to go all the way to the sides because you already have the hinge from the sides, and this is in essence the whole pocket. So now I'm going to adhere the other piece of cardstock, and I'm going to put some glue on all the scored edges to adhere the other card base to it, and that way you have a very nice pocket in the middle, very easy. So it's a really simple snail mail flipbook tutorial, so it's really good for beginners as well to create something like this, and it's just a really fun little mail to send out. I use some binder clips to keep it together to let it dry a little bit, and now I'm going to cap some pattern papers. So I'm going to make this for Marie, and I know Marie loves botanicals and vintage, so that is why I chose this theme for her, and I'm going to use a Craft Consortium paper pack. So if you want to know what I use, there's always a list of supplies in the description box of my videos, and if I can find it online, there are also links. But everything is listed down below with the color names and all the names of the collections that I used, and if I can find it online, there are links. Just remember that some of them are affiliate links and some of them are not. So depending on the size of the card base that you used, you are going to cut your pattern paper in a size, and I like to add 1/8 of an inch or 1/4 of an inch of a space to show a little bit of the craft cardstock. I think it gives a little bit of extra to this flipbook, so I didn't want to cover it all up, but you can definitely cover it completely up if you would like. You could also start with this pattern paper first before you do anything else, but I like to have the base of my flipbook ready before I do any of the decorating. So I'm just going to adhere this panel to the front, and I'm going to distress the edges a little bit with my distress ink to give it a little bit more vintage look, a little bit more warm feeling to this flipbook, and I'm going to do that to all the sides and also on the inside. So now I grab my pen, and I'm going to create a doodly border, but it's going to be a stitched border this time because Marie also loves to sew. She has sewn a lot, and she made a lot of costumes. I also believe that she studied for this. I'm not quite sure about that anymore. So I thought it was a little fun thing to add to her mail. And if you watched my creative journaling process video from the Your Creative Studio box, you remember that I cut out this piece to use, but I never used it, or it was a junk journal with me. I'm not quite sure, but I kept it, and it was the perfect mail to add this beautiful piece because I wanted to make something a little bit more spring and you know, the start of spring, so that is why I chose these pieces. I also have this label booklet from a Your Creative Studio box, and I am going to adhere that as well as a part of my collage. And I'm grabbing some washi tape. Washi tape is one of my favorite things to use. If you are a follower of mine, you know that I have a serious washi tape problem. I have a lot of boxes. I'm planning on making a craft room tour video. So I'm gonna show you all my boxes. And I'm a bit ashamed to share that with you because it is quite a lot. But also I use it a lot. I really, really love washi tape. So I added some of these pieces to my collage, and now I have this flow sticker sheet that's from an older flow book for paper lovers, and I'm going to spell out Hi Marie. I always love to add people's names on there. Sometimes I write them myself and sometimes I use letter stickers. It really depends on the vibe I'm going for and also if I feel like it's going to be a nice handwriting day. So sometimes you know that your handwriting is not gonna be great. That is when I try, when I use the letter stickers and I still want to create. So I was a bit undecisive about where I wanted to add these stickers, but I finally found a place for them. And now I'm going through my stash. I'm going to find some washi stickers that I want to use. And I'm also going to create that as a part of my collage. So with collages, it's all about layering up pieces and create little clusters. So that is what you see me do here. The H of Hi, I'm going to put that a little bit over the sticker so it feels like they are connected. And that's really the trick with collage. Don't be afraid to cover things up or layer pieces up, because that just gives it a bit more depth and a bit more definition to your project. Also, I use these cut-off pieces later on other sides of my collage as well, because they still have a pretty image on there, so I don't want to throw that away. And now I'm going to take a quote from Tim Holtz's phrase booklet, and I always pick quotes that I think that fit the person. So I chose for Marie, "Go where your heart takes you." I think that is a quote that is fitting for her. We've been friends since I started my YouTube channel, so I think we have more in-depth conversations, and I think that fits her as well. So now on to the inside. I want to create on the inside a beautiful, just embellished side, and a side where I'm going to put my goodies. So I'm going to use this pattern paper, and to give a little bit more of that vintage look, as I said before, I'm going to distress that paper, but also the inside of the cardstock. And I also always take the spine with that, because that gives a little bit of an extra vintagey look. I don't know, it doesn't feel finished if I don't take the spine as well with my decorating. So I am going to adhere this piece of pattern paper as a back piece to start my collage with. That is what I like to do. And then I am going to add a doily, because I love doilies. They are great layering pieces for collages, and they also, of course, help with the vintage look. I always adhere my doilies with tape, because wet glue tends to soak through them and you will see the glue. So if I use tape, you will not see any of the glue. And I'm going to adhere this beautiful piece that I bought from AliExpress, I believe, a very, very long time ago. And I'm going to use the same washi tape as I did on the front to create more of a cohesive look. So as you can see, I'm going for a very spring vibe with some yellows, and my latest obsession with washi dots. They are just amazing, and I love to finish up my collages with enamel dots or gems, but they are not always a very good fit for, especially if you want to send out flat mail. So I think washi dots are a very good way of have that look, but it's still flat. I have this envelope that was sent to me by one of you guys, and I thought it was perfect for this mail. So I always keep all of the things that you send me, and I try to use it myself. So this envelope was not made by me, it was made by one of you, and I thought it fit this beautiful collage. I'm going to use that as a pocket for some goodies. But of course, first I want to have a little bit more of a layering piece, and I'm going to add this washi tape. But it's a bit too white, so that is why I decided to distress it a little bit with my distress tool. So there's no new ink on it, but to give it a little bit more of that brownish tint as with the cardstock, I use that to blend it a little bit more in. So now I'm going to adhere my envelope to my place, and I'm also going to see my envelope as a way of layering pieces. So it is a way to put goodies in there, but I also want to make it look pretty and let it be a collage. So I'm very much into using different ways of die cuts to close my envelopes. So there's not really a closing, but it looks like a collage, but you can open the envelope. I don't know how to say that properly, but I'm going to use this flower die, and I'm just going to glue down half of it so you can still open and close the flap, and the flap stays closed, but it still looks very, very pretty, and it's not very obvious that that is an envelope, or well, you can see it, but you know what I mean. Going to use some of the mint green washi tape as well, because if you look on the right side, you have the beautiful light green color with the illustration. So that is why I chose another extra washi tape, and that is how I usually pick my washi tapes. I'm going off the papers and I'm going through my stash to find washi tapes that will fit the color scheme, and that is also why I have a lot of washi tapes, because sometimes I'm creating something and I'm like, I wish I had a color of this washi tape. That is how it all happens that I have so many washi tapes. So I'm going to work on the back side right now. I'm going to use this pattern paper. I'm going to do the same as I did for the front. So I'm going to cut a piece of paper that has a little bit of room around it. I think it's 1/8 of an inch, to show a little bit of the craft cardstock. And I'm also going to distress that paper and going to glue that down with just some regular glue. So I'm using Eileen's Clear Gel Tacky Glue right now. I absolutely love this glue. It's a very, very good glue, so I very much recommend it. I had some anxiety about snipping the tip or opening the tip as much as I did, but I had a lot of very good tips from us follower, and that really, really helped me, and I absolutely love this glue now. So I'm going to layer up some of these stickers, and all of these stickers are from AliExpress. So I have this beautiful brown botanical and then another little plant, and I always like to add my own sticker on the backside. So I did a rebranding and I don't have any new stickers yet, so I need to order them do the rebranding completely, but I always like to add my own sticker on the back, so people know that they got it from me. I don't know, it gives a little bit of an extra thingy. I'm going to repeat the same process on the other side, but I'm going to create the collage bit on the left side this time and not on the right side to make it a little bit different but still cohesive. I like to repeat patterns, but I also like to repeat elements. So this is an element that is returning, and I also really love this illustration. So I used this label on the front, and I'm also going to use one of these labels somewhere else to give that back to the cohesiveness. And I'm also going to do the dually border, because I could not do not a dually border, of course. And I'm using my washi tape to create a little bit of an extra thing to this collage. I don't know, it's a really an intuitive thing, I guess, to use washi tapes like this. And you can also layer washi tapes up on top of each other, and it gives a really, really cool look without less effort. And washi tapes don't weigh a thing, so it's also a very good embellishment to use on your snail mails. So I added some more of these quotes, and now I was a bit hesitant to cover up this beautiful image, but it really needed something else. So I'm going to add this butterfly. I'm going to be brave and cover up part of this image and add a little butterfly there. And now I'm going to work on the other side. So I was a little bit in doubt on what I wanted to do on the other side, and I grabbed some of the pattern papers, checked that out, and wasn't quite that. And then I remembered that I have this block of papers from the Your Creative Studio box, and it really was a very nice music sheet paper. So I thought that would be a good background to do some do a pocket on, because I decided to use a glass seam bag. So you have this transparency on top, and I'm very much into transparencies lately. Also, you saw me stuck it down upside down. I'm happy that I saw that in time. But I'm going to glue this glass seam bag down with some glue stick, so you don't see any of the glue residue through it, but you can see the music paper through it. I'm also going to add some of that washi tape and another transparency sticker. And I'm going to add some goodies in this pocket. But if Marie takes the goodies out, it still looks like a pretty collage. And I really enjoy creating pockets like this, that it, even when everything is out of the mail, it still looks pretty. It's somewhat of a challenge I give myself that I very, very much enjoy. And this is also where I'm going to add a piece of that label. So it had this postage stamp kind of thing. And I thought, well, that fits very, very well with a snail mail. So I'm going to adhere that as well on top. And I'm going to add some of these sheets for her to use, because I think that Marie would very much enjoy some of these goodies. I also have some Project Life cards that I thought she might enjoy, and also fit the color scheme of this mail, because I always do my goodies as a part of the mail. So I love it to create mails that are cohesive and that the goodies are cohesive as well. Of course, I have to share a washi tape sample with her, and I'm also going to share some of these washi dots. So I always look around on what I used for this mail, and I try to give some of the things that I used to the recipient, because I show what you can do with it, and then maybe someone gets excited about using a certain product. So that is why I always include things that I also used on the mail. And also, it looks very cohesive. So now I'm going to create my own writing paper. And these are A4 sheets of very cheap, simple writing paper. And I know that they are too big to fold up and put in my big middle pocket that we made in the beginning of the video. So I'm cutting that down a little bit. I'm going to fold them together. I'm trying to fit them inside the pocket. And as you see, there's a little bit of overhang. So I am going to cut it a little bit smaller to fit inside that pocket. You could do whatever you want in that pocket. It doesn't have to be the letter. You can add some extra Project Life cards or other bigger goodies that you want to send out. But I thought it was a very fun way to send a letter and create a letter for, or a pocket for the letter. So you see me here that I'm fussing around a little bit with folding it and getting it the right size. And once I have it the right size to fit in, I am going to decorate my writing paper. But I'm also going to create a little tabby to show her that there is a letter inside. And I'm going to use that label that I cut off earlier. I'm going to write on it, "Read me." So she can see that she can pull that little tab and then she will find the letter. So I do this folded up so I know how to put it back in the mail, but I'm also sure that it's on the place where I want it to be. And I am checking if I like it, and I very much enjoy how it looks. Also, it helps the recipient to take the letter out very easily. Now I'm going to create my own writing paper, and I love to use washi strips for that because it gives a very good impact right away, and I like to use the same washi tapes, of course. I also took a washi sticker of this beautiful flower, and I take one of these label pieces and I create this little cluster in the bottom. I don't do a lot on my writing papers because I tend to write long letters and I don't want to have to send 10 sheets of paper because they also weigh a lot. So that is why I don't do a lot on my writing paper, but just enough to make it look cohesive with the mail that I made. So as you see, I'm going to repeat certain things like the washi tape or the labels, but I'm going to pick a different flower sticker every time to, well, give the botanical feel, of course, and that it looks fun on every page, and there's something a little bit different, but it also matches together. And I very, very much enjoy doing this. It's also very fast. You could also do this, of course, to create just writing paper. If you just write letters, it's a very fun way to create a very nice pen pal letter. So here I am doing my last sheet of writing paper. And I'm going to add some more of these washi dots, and then I will stack them together and fold them up so it can fit into the pocket. And then I saw the front and I was like, I want to add something to the front as well. So if she pulls it out, she sees this beautiful flower sticker with this label. And I don't know, it just was something extra I thought of that was really fun to do. It depends on how I fold my letters inside my flipbooks on how I do this. but I very much enjoyed adding this little extra thing, and I'm going to put that in the pocket. So if it goes a little bit hard into the pockets because you didn't glue the sides of the hinge down completely, which is completely fine, but then you have to check if your paper doesn't get stuck under there. I also found this beautiful, it's twine, I'm not quite sure. And I like to wrap my flipbooks with a little bow, like it is a little present. And here I have an envelope that was together with the card bases, so you know that it will fit. I still, even though I know it's the right size, I always check if my mail fits into the envelope, because you don't want to have a beautifully decorated envelope and your mail doesn't fit. So always check if your flipbook fits the envelope that you chose. And now I'm going to create a collage on this beautiful craft cardstock envelope. I'm going to use that same paper block that I used before from the York Creative Studio kit to create this beautiful pattern paper, well, collaged background. And then I am also distressing the edges a little bit of the envelope to make it match with the inside. I'm using these paper strips that were left over from the pattern paper that I used on the inside to give a little bit more of cohesion, but it also helps to get rid of some scraps, because I have a ton of scraps, and if I can reduce them in the same project, I will do that. So that is why I always use the scraps on the envelope. And I'm going to pick another of these stickers to add to the front to give the feel of what is inside this beautiful envelope. Of course, I also have to put some of these washi dots on this side of the envelope. And I always check a little bit if it looks nice together with the flipbook. So usually I don't do a lot on the back, but because this is within Europe, I don't have to put this big customs form on the back. So I thought, well, just a little bit of fun embellishing on the back would be nice. So I just took some of these washi tapes and layered them up. And I'm going to pick one of these washi stickers with a botanical to create a little cluster. It's not that much and not big, because I usually don't do the backside of envelopes, but for this one, because I didn't have to add a cluster, I thought it was nice to add a little bit extra. Now I'm going to use more of these washi dots, of course, and that will pretty much finish up my mail for today. So if you like this video, I would love it if you would give me a thumbs up. I would also love it if you would consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. I put the notification bell on all notifications so you don't miss any of my videos. I do snail mail videos, art journal videos, mental health videos, journaling videos, all kinds of videos. So I would love it if you would come and hang out with me. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you all next time. Bye!